Hello children, welcome to AIIMS India's online classes, biology session, respiration in organisms. So we have completed the lesson and the assessment one, which include the level one questions. So let us have a discussion in the assessment two, level two questions. Are you ready children? Let us proceed. Assertion reasoning type question. Aquatic animals use dissolved oxygen during respiration. So reason, atmospheric air contains less oxygen content than the dissolved oxygen in water. So in this assertion reasoning type, what you have to do? We have to check first whether assertion and reason statements are true or not. Okay. Then next, you have to check the options. If both are true, then you have to go for whether the reason is supporting the assertion or not. Okay, children. So let us check whether the statement is true or not. Aquatic animals use dissolved oxygen. Yes, it is 100% correct. And the atmospheric reason, atmospheric air contains less oxygen content than the dissolved oxygen in water. This is a wrong statement. Why? Because atmosphere containing the more oxygen compared to oxygen dissolved in water. So here the correct statement is assertion and reasoning are correct. R is not a correct explanation of A. Assertion and reason are correct. R is not correct explanation of A. So then dissolved oxygen is more in the water. Next, during inspiration the volume of thorax increases. Reason, this happens due to relaxation of diaphragm and inspiratory muscles. So what are the changes occur during inspiration? The diaphragm come down, thoracic cavity increases. Okay, so what is the reason given here? This happens due to the relaxation of diaphragm and inspiratory muscles. When the diaphragm relax, the thoracic cavity decreases. So here let us see what is given. Yes, A is true and R is false. A is true. It is opposite given. If the relaxation of the diaphragm and inspiratory muscles takes place, means what happened, means ribs will contract, internal air pressure will increase, air rushes out. But here during inspiration the volume of thoracic cavity increases due to the diaphragm come down, lowers, and the chest expand. Okay, right. Next question. During expiration volume of thoracic cavity decreases and air is expelled out. Assertion is correct. Reason, this is due to contraction of diaphragm. This is due to contraction of diaphragm. So here also, once again, the reason is wrong. Assertion is true, but reason is wrong. So actually, the diaphragm go back to its normal position. Go upwards, move upwards. Okay. Next assertion, opening and closing of stomata is due to change of turgor pressure in God cells. When the turgor pressure increases, stomata opens, decreases, stomata closed. So in the assertion, opening and closing of stomata is due to the change of the turgor pressure is. Okay, so here both assertion and reason are correct, and the reason is the correct explanation of assertion. Next assertion, respiration in leaves takes place by the stomata. Reason, respiration in leaves occurs only during the daytime. So here assertion is true but reason is wrong. Okay, next here matching set. So what you have to do first, the known ones you have to match and select the, sometimes the code will be given at the bottom, so you have to select the right code. So before selecting the code you have to match. So here larynx is also called voice box, trachea is also called windpipe, bronchi divide to produce bronchioles in the lungs, then pharynx consisting of epiglottis. A structure which regulates the flow of air, water and food. When the air enters the trachea or when the air enters the pharynx, the epiglottis closes the oesophagus so that the air enters into trachea or windpipe. Okay, so here pharynx, epiglottis, C. Larynx, voice box which contain the vocal cords produce the sound. Trachea is also called windpipe. Bronchi is a part of trachea which divides into bronchioles when opens into the lungs. So C, D, B, A. Next. So another matching set, small matching set is given here. The organs of breathing in man, the gas expelled out and the gas take in. Here oxygen, carbon dioxide and lungs are given. So what is the organ of respiration in a human? Lungs. Okay, organ of respiration in humans is lungs. We respire through lungs. Gas expelled out, during expiration we expel out carbon dioxide. Gas taken in, we breathe in oxygen rich air. Okay, next another small matching set. Air sacs, windpipe, the muscular layer between the floor of abdomen and chest cavity. Here trachea, alveolus and diaphragm are given. Air sacs, alveoli or alveolus, also called air sac. Windpipe, trachea is also called windpipe. The muscular layer between the floor of abdomen and chest cavity or thoracic cavity. Thoracic cavity and abdominal cavity are separated by a muscular structure called diaphragm. Okay, next statement based question. Here two statements are given, just like assertion and reasoning only. The percentage of carbon dioxide is more inhaled air as compared to that of exhaled air. Next, statement 2, the capacity of the human lungs for air in a healthy person is 1500 ml. So no doubt the statement 1 is wrong, I feel. And statement 2 is correct, while the statement 1 is incorrect. Okay. So this is wrong and this is correct. Statement 2 is correct and while the statement 1 is incorrect. Next, another statement based question. So plants have special organs of respiration called trachea. Statement 2, roots breathe in air from air spaces in the soil. Okay, here also statement 2 is correct. Statement 1 is wrong. Either here stomata, lenticels or root hairs may be given means right. So here both the statement is incorrect. Roots breathe air. Actually, this is a right statement. Roots breathe in air from the air spaces in the soil. Okay, statement B. Statement 2 is correct while the statement 1 is incorrect. Okay. Next, taking in oxygen is inhalation. Breathing rate is number of inhalation and exhalation in 1 minute. Okay. Both are correct. Both the statements are correct. Next, here diagram based question. The process shown in the figure represent. Here air forced out. Ribs move back. Diaphragm move back. So here it is the exhalation process. Okay. Next. Here the lungs diagram is given. So here the three questions based on the above diagram. The part diaphragm is marked as. Here what is the diaphragm? This is the diaphragm. What is the diaphragm? Diaphragm is a muscular structure which separates the abdominal cavity and thoracic cavity. Okay, here the space is given between the two lungs for the accommodation of a heart. Okay, which part is representing diaphragm here? D. Okay. So, D. Next, the part labeled as B is. What is B? B is the trachea. Here lung, diaphragm, trachea, branchial is given. So it is trachea. Which part contains alveoli? So here part A represent the lungs contain alveoli. Okay, the part C represent the ribs. Okay, right. Next, identify the part labeled as C and D. C and D. D is bronchus or bronchi. And C is the larynx. Okay. So here, option D. This is larynx. This is bronchus. Bronchus. So the trachea, which is a tubular structure present travel through the chest cavity. It is made up of C-shaped cartilage which protect the trachea from being collapsing. So it divides into two branches called bronchi. Each one is called bronchus. Okay. It divides into the small other branches. They are called branchioles. Okay. The branchioles opens into the lungs. Okay, let us proceed. Again, assertion and reasoning question. Breathing in and out is a simple physical process. Okay. Reason. Breathing occurs only in animals and not in plants. So here the two statements are given. Both assertion and reasoning are true, and R is the correct explanation of A. Because breathing is a physical process which takes place only in the animals. Okay. But not in plants. So both are correct and R is the correct explanation of A. Next, yeast is a single celled organism that can respire anaerobically. Okay, true. Yeast is used to produce wine and beer. Okay, here also both assertion and reasoning are true and the R is the correct explanation of A. Next, assertion. When muscle cells in human respire anaerobically, cramps occur. Okay, true only. We come across in the lesson. Reason. Accumulation of lactic acid causes cramps. Okay, it is also correct. It's the correct explanation actually. Okay, so here both A and R, assertion and reasoning are true and R is the correct explanation of A. Due to the accumulation of lactic acid only, muscle cramps occur during strenuous exercises. Next, when we breathe rapidly, we inhale more oxygen. Okay, reason. When we inhale air, it passes through the nasal cavity. So here's something. Okay. So what is the passage of air? Air from outside enters into the nostrils, then passes through the nasal cavity. Then it enters pharynx, larynx, trachea, bronchi, bronchioles, and finally alveolus. Okay. Both assertion and reasoning are true and it is the correct explanation of A. So here one paragraph is given based on that comprehension type question. This is respiration is a basic characteristics of all living beings. It is an energy releasing reaction. The living cells break down complex high energy food molecules into simple low energy molecules by oxidation, forming carbon dioxide and water. By this, a large amount of energy is released, which is used to maintain life activities by the organism. Okay, this is the explanation about the importance of respiration, the process of respiration and its importance. Respiration in human beings involves exchange of gases, involves inspiration and expiration, involves oxidation of glucose. These are all the terms which we come across. So here all the above are correct. So which type of respiration is found in yeast? Aerobic respiration, anaerobic respiration, respiration using oxygen. So anaerobic respiration, so that is called alcoholic fermentation. Okay, in the process of respiration, dash following gets oxidized: oxalic acid, glucose, lactic acid, all of these. In the process of respiration, dash, so which of the following gets oxidized? So here lactic acid is a product, oxalic acid also the byproduct. So here glucose is oxidized. Okay. Right. Next question. Where does glycolysis takes place? Cytoplasm, mitochondrion, endoplasmic reticulum, ribosomes. So the glycolysis takes place in the cytoplasm of the cell. It is a common step in both aerobic and anaerobic respiration. Next, the first step of glycolysis results in the formation of glucose 6-phosphate, fructose 6-phosphate, ATP, 1,6-biphosphoglycerate. It is the glucose 6-phosphate. 1 ATP is utilized during this reaction. Next, which of the following is not a requirement for glycolysis? Oxygen, ATP, NADP, glucose. So here oxygen is not required for glycolysis. It is a common step for both aerobic and anaerobic. Means in the presence of oxygen also it takes place, absence also it takes place. Next, which of the following is not a product of glycolysis? FADH2, NADH, ATP, pyruvate. So here FADH2 is not a product of glycolysis. ATP, NADH, 2 NADH, and the 4 ATPs are produced, 2 are utilized, and 2 pyruvic acids are produced as end product of glycolysis. Okay children, I hope you understood the today's video. Thank you for watching our video. Please subscribe our channel and press the bell icon for receiving latest updates.